It's all broken. Wow, what an incredible entrance. I'm glad the bride had an amazing smile on her face because the rest of you were crying, so you may take your seat. Good morning, my name is Tim. I'm one of the pastors at City Impact Church. It's my privilege to welcome you here today on this beautiful occasion to celebrate this very special marriage. We're here with Jonathan and Natalie on their big day to witness these two wonderful people join themselves together as husband and wife before God in holy marriage. Did you like the little touch up there? Get used to that, Jonathan. There's a lot more of that to come. This certainly is an awesome occasion for this couple, for their family, and for all their friends and loved ones who are gathered here today. Jonathan and Natalie are two very special young people. They're an integral part of City Impact Church, and they and their family and their extended family have been an incredible blessing to the church and to the body of Christ. So it's our privilege, it's my privilege, and the privilege of my family to be here today to witness and to be a part of this awesome moment, the beginning of a great adventure for these two wonderful young people. This day is all about Jonathan and Natalie, but they've asked that I take a moment to acknowledge their friends, their family, their loved ones, and to thank you all for being here to share this very, very special day. Thank you for being such an important part of their lives up until this moment, and thank you for the part that you will play in their future. Because a marriage to be successful doesn't just take two. As we'll read in a moment, it takes three, but it takes more than that. It takes a tribe, it takes a village, it takes a community, it takes friends and family to be supportive, to be praying, and to love on this couple. I know that many of you will be used to very long wedding ceremonies. I can see a few heads nodding. I have the privilege of telling you that this will not be one of those. This lovely couple, love you so much that this is going to be just short and sweet, but hopefully very, very memorable. And afterwards, there will be, just out in the area outside of this room, there will be refreshments. And I'd ask that as the ceremony finishes that we all head out there, and then this room will be set up for the reception while this couple have their photos taken. Would you join me in prayer, please? Father, we thank you for this couple. We thank you for the love that Jonathan and Natalie have for each other. We thank you for the love they have for their family and the family and friends have for them, Lord God. Lord, as we gather here today, we just pray that your presence, your blessing, your anointing would be here. Lord, that everyone in this place who have come to witness the beginning of this covenant, Lord, would not only be part of this wedding ceremony, but they would be part of your family. They'd be partakers in your love and your presence and your peace, the peace that only you can bring. Lord, right now as we stand here together, we block out every other distraction, everything else that could take our mind and in another direction. And we focus on you. We give you all the glory. We dedicate this time to you today, and we pray that by your Spirit you touch every heart in this place. That experience your love. We thank you for marriage. We thank you that marriage is your design for a man and a woman to come together. And so we pray blessing on this couple today and all who are gathered here. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Well, Jonathan and Natalie have asked that I read a scripture today. And they've chosen Ecclesiastes 4, verse 9 to 12 from the New King James Version. Many of you will know this. It says, two are better than one, because they have a good reward for their labor. For if they fall, one will lift up his companion. But woe to him who is alone when he falls, for he has no one to help him up. Again, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one be warm alone? Though one may be overpowered by another, two can withstand them. And a threefold cord is not quickly broken. Of course, that third cord in this marriage, this covenant relationship that is beginning today, is speaking of God, the God factor. And both these two wonderful young people know that Their love for each other is strong. They know that they're excited for their future, but they know that they will not only lean on each other, but they will need to lean on God. They will need to trust in God. They will need God as the third person of this marriage, because with Him, this will be a success. So now we come to the most important part of today's proceedings, the wedding vows. And I'm going to ask you first, Jonathan. Jonathan, will you take Natalie as your wife in Christian marriage to live according to God's plan and purpose? Accepting headship of your home, will you love her, comfort her, protect her, honor her, and keep her in trials and in blessing? Forsaking all others, keep only to her so long as you both shall live. He said, I do, just in case you didn't hear that. Which is the correct answer.
Oh, boy.
Natalie, do you take Jonathan as your husband in Christian marriage to live according to God's plan and purpose? Recognizing his headship in your home, will you love him, comfort him, help him, honor him, cherish him in trials and in blessing? Forsaking all others, keep only to him so long as you both shall live.
I do.
Wow. Could I ask that you all please stand again as Jonathan and Natalie exchange their marriage vows?
Before God, my family and friends, I'm so blessed to take you as my wife. All that I am,
notice that Jonathan got emotional when he said, all I have, I share with you. That's something we can talk about afterwards.
Before God, our family and friends, I'm so blessed to take you as my husband. All that I am and all that I have, I give to you. All of my goals and ambitions, I share with you. All of my dreams and plans I will make with you. All of my life I will love and cherish and respect. Through the hard times I will cry with you. Through the good times I will laugh with you. Always encouraging you, praying with you and for you. As we seek God's will for our lives. You are my heart's desire. All my life it will be in you.
Now for the exchanging of rings. Rings are a symbol, a sign of unbroken unity, just as your love for one another must be. They are a seal and a reminder of this everlasting agreement, a promise of the covenant vows that you have declared to each other today before God, family, and friends.
Thank you.
The bridal party will now sign the marriage register, and then they have chosen to honour God by taking communion together as the first act of their married life. You may be seated.
Thank you.
Saints take communion together, they're remembering God's covenant, His vows to us, the forgiveness of sin, adoption into the family of God, and eternal life. These are all reflected in the emblems that represent the Lord Jesus Christ, death on the cross, and resurrection to heaven's throne. Moment before we pronounce this amazing couple, husband and wife, just to pray a prayer of blessing. Would you please join with me? Father, we thank you for this couple. We thank you for their life together. We thank you that this is a new day and a new start, a fresh day full of fresh promises, Lord, and opportunities that you have created for them and you will prepare as they walk from this room together. Lord, we thank you for the anointing upon their lives. We thank you for their heart for you, their heart for each other, for the kingdom of God, for these gathered here today. We pray your blessing, your abundant blessing, the double portion blessing upon their life. Lord, as they have been faithful to you, Lord, you promise that you will in turn be faithful to them. Lord, as they have served you in your house, we know that you will, Lord, create opportunities for them to be served, for them to be blessed, for them to walk in victory and promise. We pray over their lives, over their health, over their strength, and the future family, Lord God. We pray for the days ahead that they would be days of safety, protection, and blessing, of life and life in abundance. Lord, that you would indeed bless them from heaven. And everything that they put their hand to, I pray that they would flourish and they would prosper, that they would be an example to many in all that they do and all that they accomplish. Lord, we thank you for this day. We are so excited for all that you have for them. And we just dedicate it to you in your mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Jonathan and Natalie, you've declared before God and this congregation that you will live together in Christian marriage. You've made sacred vows to each other, symbolized in the exchanging of vows and the giving of rings. Therefore, it is my privilege to pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, whom God has joined together. Let no man separate. You may now kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, could I ask that you please stand again for the final time? I'd like to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Jonathan and Natalie Finau.